Aloha Kalikimaka family, Merry Christmas! Christmas is here, yay! Thank you for tuning in to our Christmas Eve service as we celebrate Jesus Christ, Emmanuel, God with us. We celebrate because God gave us the greatest gift of all, the presence of His Son. Not the P-R-E-S-E-N-T presence, but the presence of God Himself in the form of a baby. His name is Jesus. And what does Jesus mean? Jesus means God saves, because Jesus is the Savior. So let's make sure we know the story of Christmas. Let's walk through it together in Scripture and sing along the way as we worship Him and celebrate tonight. Merry Christmas. As we begin tonight, watch this video. We'll be reading scriptures together and going through the story of Christmas through the Bible in chronological order. Have fun, worship God, and Merry Christmas.
An angel came to see Mary.
She was doing laundry. And then the angel just appeared and she was really scared.
So Gabriel was like, Mary, you're gonna have, what? I can't say it good. Mary, you're gonna have a baby. You're gonna have a baby and you will call him Jesus. And then Mary was like, I'm not gonna have a baby yet. I'm only a teenager, I'm not married. Then the angel Gabriel told Joseph that Mary is not lying.
You are having a new baby.
And so they met up. They went to Bethlehem, which was Joseph's old town.
They ride a donkey.
I don't know.
A camel.
Oh, yeah, a camel.
She said, this donkey's fast. They tried to go to a hotel, and
they asked the keeper for a place to stay. The keeper said,
we have no rooms. Literally, no rooms.
So Mary and Joseph walked away sadly, but then he said,
the only place in here in Bethlehem that you can stay is a stable. And then he just pointed the way and they followed.
When the shepherds were taking care of the sheep,
then they saw angels.
The angels said, a new baby is getting born, who is King of the Jews.
The angel was singing,
and then the shepherd said, I think we should go there and meet him. The second, I think, said, yeah, I agree with you. And the other said, yeah, me too. They had to walk through a bunch of grass and bushes, maybe have to camp out a night. And then the wise men heard about it.
And then a star appeared.
We should probably follow that star. It's pointing down to the barn.
So maybe we should follow it. Maybe. So the wise men went to Jesus.
They gave them gifts.
A stuffed animal, like a hippo one they have at home.
Some diapers, and some wipes, and some milk, some shoes, some Jordans.
Gold ring and Latimer.
And I don't know how it would survive in that barn. Too stinky, too crowded, and ugh.
I think he probably pooped because the room was very smelly.
Thank you for coming.
He's adorable.
He's gonna be our best friend.
I love you, and you're the best baby I ever seen. There, I said it.
The new baby is gonna change the world.
All right. Tell me that is not the most adorable Christmas story you have ever seen. Well, we're going to dive into the Christmas story in the Bible, and we'll be reading together and then worshiping in between time. So enjoy and be blessed. Our first scripture reading is 1 John 4, 9 to 11. In this, the love of God was manifested toward us, that God has sent his only begotten Son into the world, that we might live through him. In this is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the propitiation for our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. This devotion that I'm going to read is from Max Lucado. It's from his book, Because of Bethlehem. People have always wondered about the image of God. Societies have speculated, tribes have meditated, and we've reached a variety of conclusions. God has been depicted as a golden calf and a violent wind and an angry volcano. He wears wings, breathes fire, eats infants, and demands penance. We've fancied God as a ferocious, magical, fickle, and maniacal person, a God to be avoided, dreaded, and appeased. But never in mankind's wildest imagination did we consider that God would enter the world as an infant. John 1:4 tells us that the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. The Word became not a whirlwind or a devouring fire, but a single cell, a fertilized egg, an embryo, a baby. Placenta nourished him. An amniotic sac surrounded him. He grew to the size of a fist, his tiny heart divided into chambers. God became flesh. Jesus entered our world not like a human, but as a human. He endured puberty, pimples, hot weather, and cranky neighbors. God became human, down to his very toes. He had suspended the stars and ladled out the seas, and yet he suckled a breast and slept in hay.
It's time to worship.
When I was but a youngster, Christmas meant one thing, that I'd be getting lots of toys that day. I learned a whole lot different when my mother sat me down and taught me to spell Christmas this way. C is for the Christ child born upon this day.
Luke 1:26-38, the birth of Jesus foretold. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she, who was said to be unable to conceive, is now in her sixth month. For no word from God will ever fail." "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word to me be fulfilled." Then the angel left.
Kingdom
of
heaven, time to worship.
Woo! Thank you, Auntie Norma. Let's sing "How Great Is Our God" in silent night. The splendor of the King, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembles at his voice, trembles at his voice. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? All will see how great is our God. How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. All will see how great is our God. Silent night, holy night, all is gold, all is bright. Oh,
great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. All will see how great is our God. And all will see how great is our God.
Merry Christmas, everyone. I will be doing a reading from Matthew chapter 1, starting with verse 18. This is when Joseph accepts Jesus as his son. This is how the birth of Jesus the Messiah came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law, and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us. When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took Mary home as his wife. But he did not consummate their marriage until she gave birth to a son, and he gave him the name Jesus. Meli Kaliki Maka.
Kingdom kids, are you ready to worship? Woo!
Who are we that you would be mindful of us? What do you see that's worth looking away? We are free in ways that we never should be. Sweet release from the grip of these chains. Like hinges straining from the weight, my heart no longer can keep from singing. All that is within me cries, for you alone be glorified, Emmanuel, God with us. My heart sings a brand new song, my debt is paid, these chains are gone, Emmanuel, God with us. Lord, you know our hearts don't deserve your glory, still you show a love we cannot afford. Like hinges straining from the weight, my heart no longer can keep from singing. All that is within me cries, for you alone be glorified, Emmanuel, God with us. My heart sings a brand new song, the dead is dead, chains are gone, Emmanuel, God with us. We lay it at your feet. Accept our offering of worship, Lord. Such a tiny offering compared to Calvary. Nevertheless, we lay it at your feet. Compared to Calvary, nevertheless, we lay it at your feet. Such a tiny offering compared to Calvary, nevertheless, we lay it at your feet. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Emmanuel, God with us.
Luke 1:39-56. Mary visits Elizabeth. At that time, Mary got ready and hurried to a town in the hill country of Judea, where she entered Zechariah's home and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the baby leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. In a loud voice, she exclaimed, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the child you will bear. But why am I so favored that the mother of my Lord should come to me? As soon as the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the baby in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed is she who has believed that the Lord would fulfill his promises to her." And Mary said, "My soul glorifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has been mindful of the humble state of his servant. From now on, all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me. Holy is his name. His mercy extends to those who fear him, from generation to generation. He has performed mighty deeds with his arm. He has scattered those who are proud in their inmost thoughts. He has brought down rulers from their thrones, but has lifted up the humble. He has filled the hungry with good things, but has sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel, remembering to be merciful to Abraham and his descendants forever, just as he promised our ancestors." Mary stayed with Elizabeth for about 3 months and then returned home.
This is a reading from Max Lucado's devotional. So here we go back to Bethlehem. This wasn't how she had planned to celebrate the birth of Jesus. Joseph led the donkey down a steep path that ended at the mouth of a cave, carved out years before by the wind and the rain, used as long as anyone could remember for a barn. He lowered Mary off the back of the donkey. He looked at her face, fatigued and powdery from the road. He apologized for the austere accommodations. She touched his cheek and smiled and entered the grotto. Joseph built a fire and heated water. Mary cleared a spot on the straw and set about the task of bringing God into the world. with calves as her witnesses and Joseph as her midwife. She did just that. Within moments, the hand of the star hanger clutched Mary's finger. The feet of the skywalker lay in Joseph's palm. No wonder the angels filled the sky with worship. Any doubt of the Father's love disappeared the night God was wrapped in barnyard towels so the hay wouldn't scratch his back. In that moment, Mary knew it was all worth it. The ache in her back, the ache in her heart, they faded away. The question of how, the wonderings of when, they didn't linger. The inn had no place for her son. That was all right. He would find a place in people's hearts.
Reading from Luke 2:1-20, the birth of Jesus. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius, the governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and the line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in clothes and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
Woo, it's cold. Please welcome our Kingdom Kids with Go Tell It on the Mountain.
Shepherds kept their watching On the eighth day, when it was time to circumcise the child, he was named Jesus, the name the angel had given him before he was conceived. Jesus presented in the temple. When the time came for the purification rites required by the law of Moses, Joseph and Mary took him to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. As is written in the law of the Lord, every firstborn male is to be consecrated to the Lord and to offer a sacrifice in keeping with what is said in the law of the Lord, a pair of doves, two young pigeons. Now, there was a man in Jerusalem called Simeon, who was righteous and devout. He was waiting for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not die before he had seen the Lord's Messiah. Moved by the Spirit, he went into the temple courts. When the parents brought the child to Jesus to do for him what the custom of the law required, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Sovereign Lord, as you have promised, you may now dismiss your servant in peace. For my eyes have seen your salvation, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and the glory of your people Israel." The child's father and mother marveled at what was said about him.
Kingdom Kids, it's time to worship. Yes, I bless her.
Mary, did you know that your baby Thank you. Mary, did you?
Matthew 2:1-12. The Magi visit the Messiah. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it arose and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. "In Bethlehem in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. They opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route.
Aloha, Legacy family. I'll be reading Matthew 2:13-23 and Luke 2:39-40. The escape to Egypt. When they had gone, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream. "Get up," he said, "take the child and his mother and escape to Egypt. Stay there until I tell you, for Herod is going to search for the child to kill him." So he got up, took the child and his mother during the night, and left for Egypt, where he stayed until the death of Herod. And so was fulfilled what the Lord had said through the prophet, "Out of Egypt I called my son." When Herod realized that he had been outwitted by the Magi, he was furious, and he gave orders to kill all the boys in Bethlehem and its vicinity, who were 2 years old and under, in accordance with the time he learned from the Magi. Then what was said through the prophet Jeremiah was fulfilled. "A voice is heard in Ramah, weeping and great mourning, Rachel weeping for her children and refusing to be comforted because they are no more." The return to Nazareth. After Herod died, an angel of the Lord appeared in a dream to Joseph in Egypt, and he said, "Get up, take the child and his mother, and go to the land of Israel, for those who were trying to take the child's life are dead." So he got up, took the child and his mother, and went to the land of Israel. But when he heard that Archelaus was reigning in Judea in place of his father Herod, he was afraid to go there. Having been warned in a dream, he withdrew to the district of Galilee, and he went and lived in a town called Nazareth. So was fulfilled what was said through the prophets, that he would be called a Nazarene. Now in Luke it says, when Joseph and Mary had done everything required by the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee on their own to their own town of Nazareth, and the child grew and became strong. He was filled with wisdom, and the grace of God was on him.
I heard about this baby boy who's come to earth to bring us joy. And I just wanna sing this song to you. It goes like this: the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift. With every breath, I'm singing hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Came to Bethlehem, expecting child. They searched the inn to find the
a place for you were coming soon. There was no room for them to stay, so in a manger filled with hay, God's only son was born. Oh, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Shepherds left their flocks by night to see this baby wrapped in light. A host of angels led them all to you. It was just as the angel said, you'll find him in a manger bed. Emmanuel, our Savior, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah. A star shone bright up in the east. To Bethlehem, the wise men three came many miles and journeyed long to you. And to the place at which you were, their frankincense and golden myrrh they gave to you and cried out, hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. I know you came to rescue me, that baby boy would grow to be a man and one day die for me and you. My sins would drive the nails in you. That rugged cross was my cross too. Still every breath you drew was hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. All right. Good reading, everybody. So, this is the story of Jesus' birth according to the Bible. As you can see, even Jesus' birth was shrouded with earth-shattering events. As Herod ordered the firstborn of each family to be killed, age 2 and below. But God used it all for his glory as it positioned Jesus and his family eventually back to Galilee, and more specifically Nazareth. That Jesus would be called a Nazarene, fulfilling prophecy and letting us know that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. Similarly, this Christmas is still shrouded with a world-changing pandemic, and God will use all of this for his glory. And still, in the middle of it all, like the Magi, we come to celebrate the birth of our Savior, Emmanuel, God with us. He knows what we are going through, and he knows how you are going to get through it. He knows the answer. In fact, he is the answer. I invite you to continue reading the gospel books of the Bible, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. See the story of Jesus as he grows, the miracles he does and why, his teachings, and ultimately his sacrifice for you and me. And the story doesn't end there. We'll talk more about that at Easter time. Love you, family. Here's Uncle Jay with a short devotion.
This is a reading from Max Lucado's book, Because of Heaven. God has high plans for you and for me. He is recruiting for himself a people who will populate heaven. It will be perfect, perfect in splendor, perfect in righteousness. One word describes heaven as perfect. One word describes us, imperfect. So what does God do? Abandon us? Start over? He could, but he loves us too much to do that. Will he populate heaven with rebellious, self-centered citizens? If so, would heaven be heaven? Colossians 1, verse 19 says, God was pleased for all of himself to live in Christ. All the love of God was in Jesus. All the strength of God was in Jesus. All the compassion and power and devotion of God were, for a time, in an earthly body of a carpenter. What started in Bethlehem cradle culminated on the Jerusalem cross, and God did it all to take us home to heaven.
Thank you all for joining us on this beautiful Christmas Eve. Merry Christmas, and God bless each and every one of you. Thank you again for being a part of our family on this virtual Christmas Eve service. Before we leave, I cannot not offer you this gift on this Christmas Eve, and that gift is Jesus himself. John 3:16-17, for God so loved the world that he gave us Emmanuel, God with us, Jesus Christ, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. And in verse 17, he sent his son not to condemn or judge us, but to save us. The Savior of the world, Emmanuel, God with us, Jesus. So tonight, if you have never made a decision to follow Jesus, I want to invite you to come and make that decision right here, right now, on this virtual meeting. And all you have to do is just repeat this prayer with me. Romans 10:9-10 says, if you confess with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the grave, you shall be saved. That is why we celebrate Christmas, the birth of our Savior King, Jesus Christ, who came, born to die and take away our sins. Not only die, but resurrect that we may have eternal life and a right relationship with God through the person of Jesus Christ. So right here, right now, I want to leave you in this prayer. And just say these words with me. Say, Father God, thank you for Christmas, for sending your son Jesus, born on this day to die for my sins, to take away my sins. And tonight I receive him as my Lord and Savior. I confess with my mouth, Jesus is Lord. I believe in my heart that you raised him from the grave. I am born again, and from this day forward, I choose to follow you and your word all the days of my life. In Jesus' name, amen, amen. Hey, listen, if you said that prayer, tell someone. Somebody has been praying for you and believing God for you to receive this gift of salvation. And if not, tell us. Give us a call, 262-8021. Leave a message if nobody answers, or go. There's a link online. Go to that link. And press that link, and somebody will be there to share with you and to go over this gift of salvation. And the best is yet to come. God bless you. We love you. In Jesus' name, Merry Christmas, everybody. Aloha. God bless.
Family, we hope you thoroughly enjoyed our Christmas Eve service tonight as we took a look at the birth of Jesus through God's word and worshiped him in song together. What a wonderful time. Thank you. Christmas is a time of giving, and if you feel like giving with your heart, you can do so at easytide.com/legacy, or you can find us at legacychristianchurch.tv. May God bless you with a wonderful Christmas together with your family and friends. God bless you and Merry Christmas. Mele kalikimaka, aloha. All right.
Jesus is the reason for the season. Merry Christmas. Woo-hoo!